Well, since they, the horde wasn't very big this first time, I guess I'll take you on a little tour here. Like I said, this is the bottom floor, first floor of the house. You're probably going down there. It's where I keep all my food and stuff in the fridge. And that's where I got some of the campfire to cook on. And in the oven, I've got my, got a few different items in there. I got some coal and stuff. In fact, while I'm here, might as well put this coal in with that coal, the rest of it. That's good for cooking. Along with some of the wood, I'll put the 6,000 wood in there with it too. And then I got my 500 cooking pots. Yay! Plenty of cooking pots. That's just scrap iron, which is fine, it can stay there too. But, and then over here, I've got my bathroom. Yes, I even put a vault door in my bathroom. The toilet, of course, empty. I got my medicine cabinet. Got a lot of my goodies. My drugs. Okay. And this wall isn't really an outer wall. There's another layer behind it, and it's reinforced concrete. I just, instead of tearing that out and replacing reinforced concrete, I decided just to keep it there because give it a little more homey look. Oops. Come on. Shut. This is the back door of the place. I better have a gun ready just in case. If I get some dipshits in the back door. And of course, I got spikes back around the back. Nope. My backyard is basically uphill. There's nobody there right now, so. Okay, now I'll show you the upstairs real quick. We have, went ahead and made a couple nightstands or cabinets. I keep all my stuff. This is my side. It says old beer here. It's the, I guess the closest thing to me. Then this one is going to be for my oldest son. He likes to play this with me, with the open sign. And I got a few things in there for him. You know, we each got 10,000 of the tokens each. So, and then, like I said, this right here is my balcony. Of course, I got spotlights set up everywhere so I can see the fuckers coming. There's a lot of improvements I need to make on this. Like I said, I need to maybe bring this out above here to where I can see better and shoot them from the front door down and then actually open the front door and let the fuckers in. So. Shut that. And this right here is my bathroom, upstairs bathroom. This will be considered the full bath. The one on the bottom is just the half bath. There's my under the sink storage, which I haven't used yet. But there's my toilet and medicine cabinet. I think I got some drugs and some duct tape and stuff. First aid kits. But I wish they had bathtubs in this game, but they don't. I realize that. They just got toilets and medicine cabinets and sinks. That's it. Oh, that's the upstairs bathroom. And then of course this is my the side entrance. Straight to the upstairs. Like I said, they didn't really do any damage to the outer wall except this of course. They did a little damage to the wood. I've got a little bit of cleanup to do once the day breaks. Let's see, I've got one, two, looks like three, four, five, 6, 7, 8, maybe. Okay, yeah, I killed one on the step here, so that was 9. And then one on the stairs there, that was 10. So we keep track of... track of how many are dead, mostly. And then this is the hatch I take down to my bunker. And of course I got my buddy Boner here. And yes, I use him to keep some stuff, even more dead corpses on him. But clubs, I got a bunch of dirt fragments I collect every time I dig. So I just put them in his ass. And then I've got a two-story refrigerator here. Top one has got all the canned goods and stuff, and you know, non-perishable stuff will last longer. And then down here I've got the meats and the pies and the eggs and the cornbread and a bunch of honey. Like I said, up here I keep some honey up there too, but I got corn and cob up here too. But what I haven't gotten yet is I need to get some beer. Drink about two of them, you get a good buzz. But after that, it starts fucking with your stamina. So then you end up slow as a friggin' snail for like a long time. So I wouldn't advise drinking too much. But anyways, this right here of the tunnel I built, and you come up here, and this is a bug out hatch. In case you gotta get the fuck out. Because there ends up being way too many. And you see, oh, and it's daylight. Daytime. 4 o'clock. And of course, you can see right there, there's a house. You see the big ass hole I put in the front of the house there. But, you know, I'll fix that. Like I said, I'll probably just put a door there. I might block that part up right there and then put a door right there on the edge and maybe do the same thing on the other side there. Put another door. That way we can come out and just shoot at them. Shoot at these fuckers. Take a first aid kit because I'm about ready to bleed. Phew. Fucker cut me and had me bleeding. Okay. Now this is another hatch to an underground tunnel I started working on. You can see it goes all the way. God damn it. I'm trying to climb down this without falling and breaking my leg. There we go. Set of stairs all the way down. And then, or set of a ladder goes all the way down. And they got a set of steps that slowly goes back up. And then stops right there. That's the part of the gun. So I made this. I'm gonna decide if I just want to dig straight, or if I want to keep steadily going up. But I haven't really decided yet. But yeah, that's the place so far. Like I said, this first seventh day horde, kind of a bummer. I don't know shit really. That. Like I said, since it's night 7 is over, it's the 8th day, 4:32 in the morning, and soon as the sun comes up, I'm gonna start collecting shit off the dead bodies and cleaning them up and shit. We'll see what we can get out of it. There's one right there. He ain't got dick, so let's clean his ass up. There we go. There's another one. Nothing. Jeez. These dudes suck. And that was one of those nurses. Running loose. Yeah, look at that. Blew the shit out of my son's car, but it left his mini bike. Hopefully I can get that damn thing back out of there, but for now, let me check this body. Iron pipe, what the hell is that? Lead weights? Look at that crap. That's weird, some of the bodies you can chop up and they disappear, but then you get some that just stay like that for a while. Okay, there's another one. So it's 10, 11, 12, 13. This is the 13th body I've found. Aloe vera seeds. I'm gonna have to fill it in that hole. Yeah, I might just make it a trap. Maybe get him another car. Maybe put it over there with mine. I'm gonna build a big fucking trap in here. Ooh, that one's useful. Some painkillers. Oh shit. Yeah, I got the fucking tallow again. Or, not tallow. Animal fat that I don't freaking need. Okay, I don't need hatches. I've already done built what I needed. There's some more rotting meat. I don't need that. Okay. And so I got some painkillers. Couple bandages. There we go. Shit. See which one's better, or is that gonna be the same thing as. Shit, I didn't mean to use the other one. Oh well, I got plenty more in the house. This is one I wanted to use, I guess, to get my full health. Alright. Like these two I'd already counted earlier. Sham sandwiches? Nah. Yuck. No damn sham sandwiches. Damn, I get too close to the fucking spikes. What's that? MacGyver's book. Learn MacGyver's secret to making scrap metal armor and more by reading this gem by the king of made-up stuff. That's cool. I think I knew how to make shit before I read the garbage book. Blue, don't be blue. Two more bodies back here.
think 15.
I don't know. I kind of lost track. Every time I kill one, if I got a spot opened up, I end up picking up zombie meat or rotted meat or tallow and shit. Or, you know, you want to call it tallow. Animal fat you can make into tallow, which you can make candles with, which I really don't need damn candles. There's that. There's the rotted meat. That shit. I bet, yeah, it gave me more. God damn it. I don't need any rotted meat. I did a little bit of damage to one of the spikes, but, well, several of the spikes, but it's not bad. They're still holding up. I don't think any ended up over here at all. Bird nest. Let's see what we got here. I mean, stay on it. Eh. Feathers. Be useful. See what I can do about all items. This is the creative part I was talking about. You can kind of get in here and make all kinds, put all kinds of stuff. Oh crap. I have to go to everything. Is it, this car is not considered an item. Come on. Where you at? Where you at? Where you at? Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Okay. Here it is. White sedan. Plant fibers I really don't need. Okay. Okay. Son's car, the back of my car. Now, let's see what I can do about getting this out of here. I don't know if I can, they'll let me do it or not. I think I put a hole in there. I'm gonna have to kind of fill some of this in. Alright, see if I can back this thing up. Yay! Turning radius on this thing sucks. Come on. Ah, fuck. I hate the turning radius. These little mini bikes, not the greatest, but they are a quicker way to get around. Okay. Yay. I'm surprised it survived. It didn't even get blown up. It just kind of fell into the hole. See, don't I have, yeah, change it off the axe. Alright. Yeah, you see where it's blowing a hole. Down there, but I've got that reinforced concrete right there, so you can't even get to it. I mean, Gonna square this out. I'm guessing you're gonna have to block that in with reinforced concrete, otherwise you'll have crawlers digging into it, getting stuck underneath there. It'll just piss me off. Cars. I tell you, I worked construction for 2 years, and before that did a lot of things on my own and stuff I learned how to do. As far as carpentry and handyman work and stuff like that. Man, if it could have been this fucking easy, damn, I would have kept it as a career. This shit's fun. To me, this is the funnest part about, funnest part of the game is just building shit. It's almost like Minecraft, but more realistic, and I think that's why I like it better. It's got a more realistic feel to it. Yeah, better put that there. Close to it. A little wet, but same 4% wet. So far not cold. Probably not cold because I'm dressed pretty warmly. Pretty good. Yep, that's my character right there. I wonder if I can make a pool. I think I can. I think there's like blocks of water you can get in creative mode. Let's see. Yeah. Start with lemons, make lemonade. In this case, do this at the same time. Start with a rocket launcher blast and make a pool. That's the idea I'm going with. don't think I have on me at the moment. Upstairs, let me use those real quick. Be a shallow end. Okay, I don't need those now. I'm going to stop this for a moment. Now what I need some concrete plates to put in the bottom. Alright, let's go back in creative. Reinforced concrete plate, there we go. That's what I need right there. Yay! God damn it. It's gonna be hard to get rid of. Damn it. Pickaxe, yes it did. I'm gonna trade it out for my shovel. A lot of times when you're dragging stuff from your backpack to your tool belt, you can drag what you want to your tool belt, put it over the item that's in its place if your tool belt is full. And then you just click on it, and then you can just get back out of it, and automatically put that object back into your backpack. I found that out just a lot quicker to do it that way, and not to switch them back and forth like that. Anyways, this is why I like using a reinforced concrete, because it freaking lasts. Probably the only type of zombies I'll probably have a problem with, which I haven't run into yet, is the cop zombies. The big fat cop zombies that puke at you. They can tear some shit up. That's why I need to make some balcony areas up around the whole house to sniper off of. I'm gonna use my sniper rifle to take them out when I seen them earlier. See, look at this. See, it's like, it starts off with 3,000 in the top layer and then 2,000 more in the second layer. If I even make a mistake with this stuff, it's like, oh fuck, it's hard to fix. It takes a while. Yay, there's my pool. Pretty good. I think I'll do this. I could use my shovel, but I'm gonna drag it back out of my backpack. I'm just gonna bring this out that way and square it off. things. I'll put one there. I really don't need one there. The three corners, that way I can set some in there, so I guess that's good. At least those zombie tears it up. But alright, let me look in the creative mode. If I remember right, I saw there's water blocks in there. Let me see if I can find it easier to just go through the search, because you can do a search on things, just type in some stuff and find some place. Let me see, water. Water source. Let's try that. Okay. Let's see what this does. My swimming pool. My swimming pool. 100% wet. You're damn right. Yeah. There we go. No good. Went from big old fucking hole in the ground to a swimming pool. I guess that means I could like build a moat all the way around the house if I wanted to. Put spikes in the water, maybe. I don't know if I can do that. Let me see. I'll get rid of my spikes. I'll find out later. But anyways, thanks for watching 7 Days to Die, the Seven Night Horde, which was pretty boring. So, but still, I hope you liked the video. So I'll have to edit this to bring it down a little bit. It looks like I damaged some blocks on this. But I guess that's okay. No biggie. Alrighty, till next time. Thanks for watching.